for the last piece, this is not too hard, but it's a little bit tricky. This is the graph. So you'll want to open up a Desmos link. And so right here on your, on the doc even, there's the link that will take you to Desmos. Click graph calculator. And you want to type in your value. So if I do y equals 50 times 1.5 to the x. And you can get that exponent by either hitting shift 6 or by using that keyboard icon that comes up. So as you can see here, the graph isn't looking so great and I really need to set my scale. And so when I go here, I'm going to change some of these values. Right now, my x is starting at negative 10 and going to 10. I don't really want to show all of that on my screen. So if I change this, if I put like negative 2, I don't have too much space over here to the left in quadrants 2 and 3. And you can see that's a little bit better. But I can still see, I can't even see my graph, not even my starting value. Now, because I answered that question, I know that there was like 2,800 and some carp at year 10. So I'd want to go to at least that many. And maybe I even want to show that on my graph. So I might kind of extend this out and go to 15 instead of 10. And then for my Y, I will go to, I'm going to see what, if I go to 3,000, what does that look like? Oop, 3,000. And that looks pretty good. And when I am changing these, I can mess with these scales a little bit to kind of make it the way I would like. I can also add labels. So my x-axis is years. I'll kind of move that along. And then my y-axis is carp. And I'm hitting these spaces here to kind of put it in the middle, but you can do it however, it's not super important. I also see, I'd like to see a little bit lower. So I might change instead of this 6, maybe I'll make this 100. And if it's not quite how I look, I can keep kind of changing that until I get a graph that I like the look of and I can fix that. And if I click right here, I can find that 10. Let me see if I can make this stay. It's not wanting to go. But I could also add a point in here if I wanted. I want the point 10. And then if I plug in this, this will act as a calculator. And it has plotted that point and I can label it on there if I'd like. And then I see to screenshot this, I want to go just a little bit higher. So I'll make that like that. So then I can see my graph. And now I want to screenshot this and get it into my project. So whatever your device screenshot method is, then you go ahead and screenshot this. I do a screen grab like this. And then I can drag it into my doc. And there it is. And that's looking pretty good. And if I need to arrange this, I might try to get this on to my page. Everybody, good luck and make sure you come to office hours or ask questions if you need.